Hey there, I'm Tom. Thanks for joining me. Today we're going to cover the retouch tools in ON1 Photo Raw. We're going to go from this to this using the retouch tools. We're not going to be using the portrait retouch, as that a lot of times makes the skin lose a lot of texture. And today, the look is to be able to see more texture in the skin when retouching, instead of making it all look smooth and plasticky. ON1 has a great set of retouching tools, including the spot healing brush, the perfect eraser, the retouch brush, and the clone stamp. So we'll go over all of those. So of the four tools, the spot healing brush is truly a non-destructive tool because you can go back even after you save the image by hitting the check mark in the lower right corner, then reopening it up in develop, you can still access all the times you use that tool and make adjustments to it. The other three tools are non-destructive as they don't change your JPEG or RAW file, but they are kind of baked into the ON1 settings, so the only way to remove them from your current file is to go up to your settings and reset all retouching tools. You can't just remove, say, the perfect eraser or the retouch brush or the clone stamp. All right, but enough about the boring part. Let's get into this image and take it from here to here. So first up, choose the proper camera profile. The best profile for this image was the ON1 portrait setting. So that took it from here to here. Adjusted the exposure slightly, contrast, and the black point, but that's all that was needed done to get the image looking like this. Next, let's go ahead and reset the retouching tools. So let's take a look at the four tools and when to use them. One of my favorite ones is the retouch tool. I'm going to zoom in a little bit by doing Command or Control Plus. Hold down the space bar so I can move the image. And let's just take a look at this area on the forehead. So I'm going to hit the letter R for the retouch tool, and you can access them up here as well. So with the retouch tool set at 100 opacity, you can just go over little spots, and it's going to use texture next to the area that you clicked on to fill in. So it can do a fairly nice job of retouching. Sometimes on larger areas, though, it doesn't work as well. So up here, it's just not doing as good of a job as other tools. So I'm going to come back and reset everything and look at another tool that is better for this. And that would be the spot healing brush, which the shortcut is the letter Q. Here, it's going to pick an area right next to it and use that for the texture. And you have control over the area. So red is the removed area and green is the source for that. So if the source isn't looking right, you can just click on that and pick an area that's giving you a little bit better grain structure or skin texture. And you don't just have to click, you can click and drag to pick a bigger or better area that you want to change. So see how nice that is now compared to how the retouch brush did for that one little area. The other part about this is it is non-destructive when you use the spot healing brush. We can come up here, hit the check mark to apply that retouching. We can close out of here. We are back in Browse, and we can take that image back into Develop by hitting the letter D, and we'll zoom in again, Command or Control Plus. I did Command or Control Minus, and you can do Command or Control Option Alt 0, and that will bring you into 100%. And that's under View, Actual Pixels. So we are back looking close up here. And what I wanted to show you is if we hit the letter Q again, we have all those retouching points that we've already done. So I'm going to just do a couple more here. And those look like moles, so I'm going to leave those in. And let's try a click and drag for a little bigger area, and then we want to be real careful of what we select. And that looks good. We'll come back up to the top. And the nice thing is you can use the bracket keys to make it smaller or larger. All right, so again, that's looking really nice. Once we're happy with it, we'll go up to the top and hit the check mark. And let's take a look at some of the other tools. Perfect Eraser, that is a content-aware type brush. That is Shift-Q, or go up here and select it. And that is really good for loose strands of hair. So we use the bracket key, just kind of go over an area and it will remove it. When we're moving hair, usually it's just the ones that are going straight up. Ones that have soft bends, those look like wispy hairs, and I tend to leave those in. All right, so that works really well. It doesn't necessarily work real well when you're retouching skin. If we go in here, we may have to zoom in close. I'm going to do Command or Control Plus so you can really see that. See that pattern it just put in? It doesn't look like the texture of the skin. So I'm going to do Command Z to undo. And again, if I was going to retouch that, I would either use the retouch brush, which is the letter R, hit that, and that's much better. Or again, we'll do Command or Control Z, bring it back, and we can do the spot healing brush, which is amazing for skin because you can select the area that you want to adjust. And you can always go back. So if I zoom out just a touch, and we hit that letter Q for the spot healing brush, we can go back and delete any of those by clicking on one of those and then hit the delete button. So that's how it's non-destructive. And we can always add more. Okay, so that is all looking really nice. Let's take a look at the clone stamp tool. The clone stamp tool shortcut is Shift S. And with that, you're going to sample an area. You get to decide on the feather and the opacity. So let's just take a look at one way to use that. And I'm going to lower the feather just a bit. Normally, I don't recommend going below 50%, but on a hard texture area like this to the right, we will select a source by going to Option or Alt, and then we'll paint over, set the source, Option or Alt, paint over, and that works really well. It's also another way to remove strands of hair. Option Alt to set, and then just go close to the size of the hair and come through. And that looks real nice as well. Another great use for the clone stamp tool is for the darker areas underneath the eyes. But for that, we want to keep in texture and make it look believable. So first I'm going to up the feather, lower the opacity way down. 30 is probably a little strong even for this, but we'll give it a try. We'll do Option Alt, select a source, in the lighter area, get a fairly big brush and smooth over. Okay, so we still have the texture. And that's looking pretty good too. I'm going to undo that with Command Z. So I undid the clone stamp underneath the eyes because I'm going to show you my favorite way of tackling that issue. And that's with the retouch brush. Again, that was the letter R, or go up here and select retouch. But instead of 100%, we're going to really lower that down. And all we need to do is to increase the brush size and go over that. And it just softens it up nicely. And it does it in a very even way as well. So it keeps it very believable. It's also great for shine. She doesn't have much shine, but if she did have shine, going over that at a lower opacity looks great. Another great use is for small, kind of troubling areas, like on the side of her mouth. Even though we did some retouching there, I would just kind of highlight that, and it's just going to soften that one area. The reason for that is we're tackling small areas instead of softening all the skin. We're just doing small little areas, and that helps keep the believability that she has flawless skin. And she does have great skin, but we're taking it from here to here. And here's a pro tip. As photographers and retouchers, we love to have our retouching on a separate layer. And that's so easy to do in a program like Photoshop. You can also do that with ON1 Photo Raw. So here we have the image. We do have retouching on it. If we hit the letter Q, we'll see all the different areas that were retouched. What I'm going to do is come up to the layers palette for this pro tip and hit the duplicate. It's going to add a layer on top. Let's just double click on the words and we'll rename that retouch and hit enter. Now we have the retouching on that. Well, just so you can see it, I'm going to turn off that layer, select the base layer, the original file that we did all that retouching on. We'll go to settings and hit reset all retouching tools. Now we have that original image back, but if we click on our retouch one, all the retouch is there. And the reason for that is if you ever over retouch something, if you have it on a separate layer, you can go up to opacity and adjust that and bring back small amounts. So that's a great way to do it, to be able to control your retouching separate from the actual image. Hope you enjoyed this pro tip. And then finally, let's take a look one more time at that spot healing brush and see how you can tackle big areas too. So if we look at this image, we have this big line going across. We can use the letter Q for the spot healing brush. We'll just take this up and come through. And now we have to be careful where we sample from to have it match up to the hair. But if you play and drag around a little bit, you'll find something that usually works really nice like that. And if we zoom out, doing Command or Control minus, we can even take care of this big spot over here. Remember, red is what is moved and green is the source. So with the source, we just want to pick a pretty area on the image. And that's a great way to remove that as well. So again, we went from here to here using the retouch tools. So let's just take a final look at this image. There are any things we can do to improve it. Any distractions? things that are pulling me away are areas of contrast, and that are these small dots on the concrete. They're not really adding anything to the image, so I'm going to remove them. And the best tool for this, spot healing brush. Let's do that. And again, just clicking and dragging on the green to pick a source that I'd like. Looks great. I will hit the check mark, and then in the bottom right corner, hit the check mark. Everything is applied to the side card file, and we are set. All right, so those are the four retouch tools. Great way to enhance any image. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you learned something from this tutorial about the retouching tools on ON1 Photo Raw. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe so you'll be notified of future tutorials. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave them down below. I appreciate you joining me, and until next time, keep shooting.